This is Greg Pasternak. I'm in the South Coast region today. I'm on Route 166 east of Santa Maria, California. And I'm visiting the Cuyama River. And as you can see, it's very warm and dry, although because I'm here in springtime, it's actually pretty pleasant. But anyway, so with this river, if you look at the valley, we always start by looking at the valley. The valley here classifies or numerically is a confined valley, but in terms of the classification, there's a little bit of a divergence here where one classification has partly confined and the other one has confined, and I don't think that's a really big deal. It just depends on where you are. Where we're looking right now is we're looking upstream, and the site where the measurements were made were actually around the bend, but there isn't a good place to park over there. I found a really nice overlook here. But anyway, if you look at the creek here, or stream, or whatever, what you can see is, of course, it's dry today. From up here, it looks primarily fine-grained sediment, meaning, sand, and I see a veneer of mud. But I also can see some large angular cobbles, and we'll have to get down into the channel to check that out more. You can see that in this section, the channel is very, very flat and uniform looking. So that's sort of interesting. It does classify as a bed undulating channel for the statewide classification, I believe, as bed undulating. So anyway, we'll scope out the morphology more from the bottom, but I just wanted to make a video first up here on the hillside so you could see the valley context and get a little bit of an overlook. As you can see, there's a lot of vegetation present and very dry climate species that are here. Okay, so the next video will be down in the channel. I'm now down in the Cuyama River on the riverbed, and you can see a bunch of things here. First of all, when you look at the riverbed here, it is very, very flat. And we would call this a plain bed. So I don't see any bed undulation here. Now again, where I'm standing is not the actual measurement site, but there's, this looks fairly, as we would say, uniform bed as you can find. Another thing you can see is along the side, there is some bedrock. We're right up against the hillside on this side. It's wider on the other side, but you can see that this is a really large river for being a confined river. I mean, that's not unusual. I wouldn't say it's that large, but anyway, but compared to some of the other sites I'm visiting, I'm at the north end of the South Coast region between South Central and South Coast, so it's a little bit transitional. Another thing you can see here is the vegetation that's growing right on the riverbed. So there's willows here, and having willows like right in the riverbed, that tells you that this is really dry. We've been in drought conditions for a while, and so there isn't a whole lot of flow. You may see some green, it looks like paint on the ground. That's because I'm at a U.S. Forest Service site, and they are doing some kind of spraying here for whatever they're doing. There are also places you can just see on the periphery where it looks like there are some willow posts that have been planted. So even though it's the riverbed, it looks like they're doing some riparian restoration. Maybe they're trying to make the channel more constricted, or I'm not sure why. But in any case, as far as the classification goes, again, this is a confined gravel cobble, and then differing between both classifications, the South Coast and the statewide, agree that this is bed undulating or riffle pool, or different ways of sort of phrasing that. It's a relatively large river for that kind, it seems like to me. But I think something here though is just the fact that the bed is so uniform, and again, I couldn't get in, it's quite a ways of a hike up to where the measurement site is from here. But from what I could see from the road, I don't think it's gonna be that different. There are some more tributaries coming in that could be creating some more bed undulation where the measurement site was compared to where I am a little bit farther downstream. That's about all I can think of for this site. So this is the only site on this particular trip where I'm visiting South Coast sites. I may make a bunch of videos on a trip later on, but this is the farthest I'm sort of ducking down to catch this. This is a pretty cool sight to just see the dry riverbed here. But the conditions here are quite uniform. You know, a little bit of riparian vegetation on the flank. Farther downstream, the floodplain gets quite a bit wider, and it is highly vegetated with willows. Okay, so that's it for this site.